Imagine this. You walk into your house and all the walls and ceilings are covered with gold. You have a massive flat screen TV on the wall and everything is completely clean. The kitchen counters are all granite. Everything's just really nice, but none of it's real. And you take off your glasses and everything goes back to normal. In the not so distant future, this could be reality where we decorate our homes with not real things, but virtual things using augmented reality. And that's what we're gonna talk about today. Could be pretty interesting and fun to think about. Let's get started. Now that might sound pretty insane, but I don't think it really is gonna be that far off. So let me explain how and why I think it's gonna happen. So as you know, virtual reality has gotten more and more popular these days. Whether it's with the high-end Oculus Rift or HTC Vive you hook up to your computer, or the kind you just use on your phone. And we're even getting true augmented reality with Microsoft Hololens, which is able to actually put opaque holograms into your field of vision. Right now, these technologies are pretty big and clunky, like with any new stuff. But still, I'm starting to see how we might get to the point where eventually everyone uses augmented reality practically all the time. Now, getting to amazing augmented reality will take longer than amazing virtual reality, but I think in the end, the two will basically combine into one, though I'm getting a bit ahead of myself. So as I said, right now we have lots of virtual reality devices, which are actually pretty incredible, especially the HTC Vive, which does room scale tracking, where you can use the whole room as a game area. And as time goes on, it's only gonna get more and more realistic to the point where you can use your whole house as a play area, and the headsets will just be completely wireless. So the main idea behind virtual reality is that it completely replaces your surrounding environment. Right now, at least, you have to put on these big headsets that cover your eyes so you can't see what's truly going on around you. Augmented reality, on the other hand, like the name suggests, it adds to the real world without necessarily replacing it altogether. When you put on HoloLens, for example, you still see the room that you're in, but now there are virtual objects in it as well. And the technology uses information about the room so these virtual objects can actually interact with the real room. So it's not that difficult to see how augmented reality might improve over the years, going from only being able to add rudimentary objects to the room, then to more realistic and interactive objects, and then eventually to useful things like a fully functional virtual TV. Imagine that. Instead of having a huge TV that you mount to the wall, just put on a pair of glasses and it puts a virtual TV on the wall instead. Then with all that, I don't think it's hard to imagine when augmented reality can eventually replace anything and everything in your field of view. Not only will you have a virtual TV, but virtual paintings, virtual wallpaper, virtual computer monitors, whatever. It kind of sounds awesome and sad at the same time, like you'd be looking at all this awesome stuff and none of it is actually real. I can kind of imagine like this dystopian future where everyone just has the same blank furniture, all the walls and couches and tables are just like completely white, but you have these contact lenses that makes everything look different. I mean, I doubt that would actually happen, but I could totally see maybe everyone in the future having a room in their house that's a designated virtual room that could change into whatever, and I actually think that would be pretty cool. So you might be thinking, well, that just sounds like pure virtual reality at that point, and I guess you're kind of right, which is what I meant by virtual reality and augmented reality combining into one. I think eventually augmented reality is going to catch up to virtual reality headsets, so they become obsolete. Once that happens, you'll just have one device that can either project only some stuff in front of you, as well as just replacing everything altogether. But of course, it would still take the real world into account so that you don't bump into stuff. I think that's still a long ways off though, simply because virtual reality is so much easier to accomplish, technically speaking. You just take some good lenses, a screen, and bam, you can put yourself into a virtual world. I mean, even phones these days do it, and that should tell you something. On the other hand, true augmented reality is not so easy. There aren't any consumer-grade headsets for AR out there, except for HoloLens, which is still a developer kit and insanely expensive. And even though HoloLens has amazing tracking and hologram quality, it's pretty low resolution and only takes up a tiny fraction of your field of view. Now, if you've been following Apple at all, they recently talked about how they're doing a heavy push for augmented reality, but to be honest, the kind of AR that they're showing off isn't what I would call true augmented reality. It's basically just using your phone's camera to look at the world on a phone screen and then adding things to it, it's not even remotely close to HoloLens. It kind of reminds me of every time people talk about augmented reality in the context of Pokemon Go, which is like the worst possible example of augmented reality I can imagine. I don't care what anyone says, but just overlaying an image onto a video doesn't automatically make it augmented reality. The Pokemon didn't even like interact with the environment at all, except sometimes correctly standing on a surface, and that was it. But at least with Apple, it seems like they're moving in the right direction. Their software is able to apparently detect surfaces, but also the scale of objects it's looking at. So if you add an object virtually, it's the right size. And if you add multiple objects, they can interact with each other and the real world, like a lamp shines on both objects. In that case, I guess you could call it augmented reality. It's just not something that is gonna make people say, wow, I don't think, because you're just looking at it on the screen. In most cases, I think it's just gonna be pure novelty. And pretty much the only useful case I can think of for that type of augmented reality is one they mentioned about like shopping for furniture online, where you can hold up your phone into your room and it will place a virtual piece of furniture in there so you can get an idea of what it would look like in your room. And I guess that could be pretty useful actually. In any case though, I guess we're gonna have to start somewhere. It's not gonna be perfect right from the get-go. But what about some other cool uses for augmented reality? The possibilities are pretty much endless, even outside your house. So even just walking down the street, you could get information about shops you're going past, like reviews, store hours, that sort of thing. And actually Google announced that they're developing a feature that does just that kind of stuff with their upcoming Google Lens software for phones. Again, it uses your phone, but it's definitely more augmented reality than like Pokemon Go. You just hold up your phone to your shops or whatever, and it uses things like your phone's location, compass, and maybe even reading text to figure out what store you're looking at. And then it displays all sorts of information. Though I'm not really sure that would be any easier than looking it up yourself with the Maps app. Also in the future, maybe there will even be some sort of social aspect to augmented reality. Like people can choose to have their social media profiles above them or something. Personally, I think that would be pretty creepy and I wouldn't want it, but you just know that there are plenty of people out there who would do it. And what about if you're just driving down the road? There could be a lot of uses there. Like the first thing that comes to mind is GPS directions, where it can tell you exactly what lane to be in, showing you visually, or where to turn without even taking your eyes off the road because it's all projected right in the road. Though I think by that time we might all already have self-driving cars anyway, might not be a point to it. If we want to get really speculative, we could think about how we might be wearing these augmented reality glasses if they come out. I actually think it will be hard to get these to catch on for a few reasons. We saw how Google Glass turned out, and I think the big reason it failed was you pretty much looked like an idiot wearing them. Even though they were like the latest state-of-the-art technology, people would still just think, what the heck is on your face? So I bet the only way that any type of high-tech glasses would take off are if they're either unnoticeable or so ridiculously useful that no one cares what they look like, but both of which probably won't happen anytime soon. I mean, sure, people might wear them while driving because then it doesn't really matter, but I doubt that they would do it when they're just walking down the street. I guess at some point things will just get so advanced that they'll just be able to fit everything into a contact lens, but we're obviously nowhere close to that yet, but you know it'll happen eventually. You know, I personally wouldn't be surprised if augmented reality contacts came out within like 50 years, easy. If you think about how we've come so far in the past 50 years, it's pretty insane. Like the first microprocessors weren't even made until the 1970s, and now we literally have the first self-driving cars coming out, and the first iPhone came out just 10 years ago. So we know that technology progresses exponentially, so I don't even know if we can imagine what it's gonna be like in 50 years. But like I said, there's some stuff you just know will happen eventually because it kinda has to, right? Flying cars, yeah, obviously that'll happen, just maybe not for a long time. Computer chip that you put in your brain automatically does augmented reality all the time. You know, maybe we're already in the Matrix and we have no idea. Who knows? But all right, enough wild speculation. Let's get back on topic. I actually do think that augmented reality is gonna come faster than most people think. I mean, Microsoft HoloLens pretty much came out of nowhere when Microsoft announced it just a couple years ago. And having used it as a first generation device, That thing is seriously amazing. I wouldn't be surprised if we see consumer versions of it hitting the shelves within like 5 years that are many times more powerful than what we have today. But you know what? I think that's enough crazy talk for now. Think too much about this kind of stuff, you'll just go nuts. But I'm sure you guys have lots of thoughts on all this. So we can talk about that down in the comment section. If you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here. You can just click those if you want. If you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. Again, I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys. So thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.